What's up, guys? Perfect in between here, bringing you the Dishonored playthrough as promised. So basically, the way this is going to work, it's going to be a combination of post and live com, just so I can insert some kind of lore momenty type things into it whilst I'm going. Yeah, it's going to be a stealth playthrough. I don't want to say clean ghost because it probably won't be, and that takes a lot of restarts. So, but yeah, it will be me trying to go through as stealthy as possible. So, yeah, let's get straight into it.
Corvo, if only there was someone else I trusted to send, so that you could remain near. But there is no one else. And the Spymaster was right to insist that I send you. The plague has taken so many, and we must find a cure. When you are near, my heart is at peace. Emily and I will count the days until you return. Hurry home, and bring good news.
Steady hand. That's it. Watch it.
Cast off live.
Casting off. We're away. Take us straight to Dunwall Tower. Lord Corvo has news for the Empress, and we've come a long way.
A long way to bring bad news. The sailors say there's a curse on us. Black magic.
Superstition. For all we know, there's a cure for the plague by now.
Maybe. We live in strange times. Sending the Empress's bodyguard away for a couple of months. That's unusual.
Well, this was important. We need help with the rat plague. Waiting for your news, Corvo.
Alright, so here we are in Dunwall Tower. Make sure you take a good look around. There's a lot of stuff to be buying to find. But also, spoiler alert, you come back here.
Yes, yes.
Later on in the
pressure
game.
Was too low.
So, yeah, it's always good to take a look around and kind of plan how you're going to come back.
Sokolov's changed everything.
Hello, sir.
Corvo, you're back! Will you tell me about your trip, please? Were there any whales? Wait! Let's play hide and seek first. I'll cover my eyes and you hide. Do you have time? Mother's busy talking to that nasty old spy master.
Oh, you don't have to do this. It just teaches you how to... It's basically just teaching you the stealth mechanics. And up there you can see Sokolov
and
higher up see a candle. I really like how they've done all the I really like how they've injected kind of background characters or main characters.
Come on.
Into the just as you come
Let's
into it.
Let's see if you're still good at this. I'll hide my eyes and count, and at the end of the countdown, I'll try and find you. Okay, I'm going to count to 10. Find a place to hide.
Really, if you hide anywhere, she never finds you. I usually like to come up here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
We don't even have to be stealthy. Just go.
9, 10. Here I come.
Another thing to note is when you're peeking, so long as you're behind cover, no one can see you. Provided that they're not behind you or don't have the I can see you through anything glitch.
What about here?
No.
Okay, you win. You should go now. Some mother can see you too. While you were gone, Mother seemed very sad. I think she missed you.
Agent, bodyguard, and possible lover of the Empress Jessamine Caldwin I, and later, mentor to her daughter, Emily. Corvo was a Sarkonnen sellsword assigned to serve the Empress as a diplomatic gesture. But the specifics of his assignment, and who gave it to him, remain unknown. He is noted as being mysterious and quiet, with Wallace Higgins and Trevor Pendleton claiming that, despite his high social status, little is known about him by those in court. It is believed by numerous citizens of the Empire, including that of the Outsider, that Empress Jessamine to the young Lord Protector as a lover, and that the heir, Emily, is a product of the affair. 6 months prior to the start of Dishonored, Corvo is sent on a mission around the Isles to seek help or a cure for the plague that haunts the city of Dunwall, the heart of the Empire. Whilst Jessamine is initially reluctant to send Corvo, she consents at the behest of her royal spy master, Hiram Burrows, who was busy plotting.
Welcome home, Lord Protector. Stop moving, Campbell. And you, Corvo, welcome back. From wherever you've been.
They sent him all around the Isles to beg for aid.
A waste of time. My elixir will banish the plague from this city. Now keep still a moment, High Overseer Campbell.
I'm not so sure that painting looks like Campbell.
You saw my improvements to the waterlock. I'm sure the Empress is eager to see you. Hey, Corvo?
That's just a little bit.
Things are bad. Could the city get any worse?
Everyone kind of thinks that there's a romantic thing going on between the Empress and the and Corvo. And yeah, I can see that. I'd ship it.
They're sick people, not criminals.
We've gone beyond that question, Your Majesty. They're
my citizens. And we will save them from the plague if we can. All of them.
Empress Jessamine Caldwin, first of her name and second of the House Caldwin to rule the Empire of the Isles. Jessamine inherited a prosperous empire from her father, Yuhorn, but a series of conflicts and the emergence of the Rat Plague sought to undermine the unity of the Empire and began to crack and crumble. Jessamine committed herself to a just and compassionate rule, doing whatever it took to alleviate the suffering of her people. She rejects Hiram Burrows' proposal to establish quarantines and deportation programs to stem the infectious plague in an effort to preserve her own soul. Jessamine was both loved and hated by the people she served, with commendations and condemnations found throughout Dunwall in the form of graffiti and overheard conversations. Her love and trust ultimately cost her own life, blinding her to the schemes of her royal spymaster, Hiram Burrows.
We will not speak of this again.
Mother, Corvo is back.
Thank you, Emily. Leave us, please.
As you wish, Your Majesty. Corvo, 2 days early, full of surprises, as usual. Follow me, Captain. We should leave them alone.
That can be taken as two things. Either, oh my god, Jessamine and Corvo, or, you'll see in a second.
It's a fair wind that brings you home to me. What news have you brought? I hope that one of the other cities had dealt with this before, knew of some cure. This news is very bad. We're at the breaking point. Cowards. They're going to blockade us. They'll wait to see if the plague turns the city into a graveyard.
Are you okay, Mother? You seem sad.
Yes, don't worry, darling. Mother is fine. Wait, where are the guards? Who sent them away?
Mother, look! What are they doing on the rooftop?
What? Emily, come here!
Alright, these assassins, you don't actually have to kill. I'm not sure whether it counts against you if you do kill them. One guy can shoot in the face, that's a good one.
Corvo, thank you. If you hadn't been here...
No more! Not again!
Mommy!
No! Get away from her! Corvo!
Mommy! Get away! Corvo!
Corvo! It's all coming apart! Find Emily. Protect her. You're the only one. You'll know what to do. Won't you? Corvo.
Ward us all. Look at what he's done. Yes, he's killed the Empress. What did you do with young Lady Emily, traitor?
Her own bodyguard. Ironic.
I'll see you beheaded for this, Corvo. Peg him.